Next try.
Switching the scenes, up into the game. Let's go for the final. No more Reese left. This game is game deciding. This
Yes.
game is match deciding. You can't see my pretty face anymore. Okay. Okay. It's basically the same map.
And Project Belgium is instantly moving forward with two hills. And the same as Everton doing.
Oh man, maybe we will see something like that's in the last game again. What's the prize pool if there is one? It's honor and love.
Yeah, considering the fact that there's no prize pool, they're playing so serious.
Yeah.
It's really nice to see.
Okay. This is a pretty...
Never mind.
Yeah.
This is pretty chill.
It's a pretty chill wall, yeah.
So
honor,
well,
yeah.
What are we going to talk about now for the next hour?
We could start something like a film if you want.
Okay, let's switch back to this game in an hour.
Yeah.
No, it's pretty nice, especially for Abitend that this war drops so peacefully.
Doesn't work, Philos. Fast forward doesn't work.
Damn it.
I'm sorry. Maybe we should set up a rule like we need to play on fast.
Black Forest on fast, yeah, that would have been good. Well, what can we say now?
I like how LB10 is collecting wood with those two villagers on the way home.
Yeah, that's nice.
Fire Nation, Erich Müller, tell us about how you got into Age of Empires. Oh man, for this story I have the right man on my side right now. I think you can tell it.
Yeah, you remember it better, like... I mean, I showed the game to you, but like, when was it?
You're way younger than the average player, of course. I think I am. Okay, so I'll tell the story. I would just activate Real Log and don't do anything for the next half an hour.
Yes.
So, the guy who's on my side here, the Jake AOE, is basically something like my cousin.
Something like my cousin?
I'm sorry, he is my cousin. Once upon a time, Philos, that's right, once upon a time. Once upon
it's
a time.
Story time.
When I went to my cousin's place, when I was, I think, 6 years old? Makes sense. It was 6 years, right? 6 years old, right?
Probably, yeah. I think I was like 11. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I was 6 years old. He was like 11 years old. And I just went to his room and saw... No, it was actually in Lena's room, right?
Probably, yeah. Lena had this on her computer as well.
Okay, yeah, so it was in the room of my cousin, is of my female cousin, is that right?
Of my sister, basically, yeah.
Okay, yeah, and they just played Age of Empires, and I fell in love with this game instantly, and Jake allowed me to play the first chapter of the William Wallace campaign, and I think I did pretty well, and I was just absolutely on fire, Fire Nation. It was a joke, but it was bad, I'm sorry. And since then I've never stopped playing this game because I've never had a good computer. So basically, Age of Empires.
No, Project Belgium lost the villager to the poor. Sorry, but
oh, man.
I thought nothing would happen, but Project Belgium lost the will. Oh man, continue.
Oh man, and yeah. So, I've never had a good computer before buying this one, so Age of Empires was basically the only game I could play. And yeah, that's the story.
Age of Empires 2 and Titan Quest, right? Those were the two
Age
games.
Of Empire, so it was basically Stronghold Crusader, Age of Empires 2, Age of Empires 1, Titan Quest, and Age of Mythology.
Yes.
And maybe
same games that I played.
Maybe Trackmania Sunrise. And Spore. So, Streamshed, you need to know, like, every game I've played until 1 year ago, it was a game that Jake recommended me or showed to me. And
yeah, probably.
I think you never disappointed me, never, with those recommendations. I think there wasn't a single game I didn't like.
Yeah, man. And all the games that I played, I just played because of my father, so you have to thank him.
Yeah. And I remember the time where you started showing Titan Quest to me, and I also fell in... Oh, and Minecraft. You recommended Minecraft also to me.
Yes,
We
true.
shouldn't forget Minecraft. I played a lot of Minecraft back in the days.
Just the
And
typical bad PC games, right?
yeah, I could run Minecraft on lowest settings with like 25 FPS and it made fun.
Yes, the same for me.
Yeah. And it's also I fell in love with Titan Quest, and one day it was my birthday, and some days after my birthday I went to your place again, and you had a present for me. So you and your father, and I think it was a present from your family.
My mother actually, she decided and bought it.
And I was just so confident it would be Titan Quest, and I was so happy opening this, and it was Spore. And I've never heard of Spore before, so I was kind of sad in that moment, but then I played Spore, and Spore was very cool as well, so.
It was a cool game as well, true.
Yeah. Actually, look at Project Nagi. He was going for his extra
Oh
boar and got attacked
no.
by two Jaguars.
The Project Belgium is making this Dark Age way more interesting than it needs to be.
I think he's doing this on purpose.
Maybe he's not paying attention as well. Just listening to your story, maybe. Just turned on the
Oh
stream and.
man. I'm all set for a chill 120 minutes game. We all are.
Yes. Is
No,
nice.
Loom really is worth it. So now Loom really. Oh yeah, but they didn't. I think no one of them did Loom. No.
LB10 actually did boom.
Oh, I see, I see. And he has one villager less.
Yeah, that's weird. Oh no, he clicked up earlier. Maybe that's the reason.
So yeah, that's yeah, and one more thing. Age of Empires is the game which I went to gaming with. Gaming on PC. LB10 is also. Wow, it's so fortunate for LB10 that the Jaguar is done, because the Jaguar is blocking the boar for him.
Oh yeah, true.
I've never saw that before.
I think this is why I did Loom, right? Without Loom, this will would have been dead long ago.
This is interesting. He could lose his villager.
If you want to mention something as well, like LB10 went for 8 fishing ships in the small pond.
What the f man, what is he doing?
Such an amazing food book. Such an amazing food.
Oh,
Such an amazing food boost for him,
so he
and
can do even earlier uptime. He maybe just needs to do plus one. But no, he's going for plus two since he needs to build the market and the blacksmith as well.
yes, and kind of unfortunate for Project Bertram, right? He has just two lakes as well, and just like one shawfish in the one lake, so it's not worth the docking, but.
I spectated a game between two pros. So I practiced casting
Yeah.
this day earlier, earlier this day, I'm sorry. And I also saw one of the guys. I think it was a Xiao Fan, if you know him.
Xiaofan, yeah, he's
Sh
playing a
sh
lot these days.
Xiao Fan.
I don't know how you pronounce
And
it.
yeah, they played Arabia, and Xiao Fan also had a pond and with one shorefish, and he actually built a dock and was going for the shorefish with two fishing ships on Arabia. I've never seen
Yeah.
that before.
I don't know if that's worth it on Arabia, but Black Force definitely. But I saw like troll games on Viper where he did it with Melee, I think, and then like those infinite fish traps.
Okay, so the problem with maybe those Black Forest games are way more interesting if you play Regicide Black Forest and Starting Age Castle Age. But no, it would be way too RNG based if you just be able to spam out your unique unit and rush the enemy before he can build the wards.
Yes.
Why
If you
would
do
you?
Regicide, you can still do like Dark Age. It still speeds up the game for like 4 or 5 minutes even. Maybe even way more.
I think you
Just
need at
because you
least
start
four
with more
shorefish in the
resources.
pond to make it worth it. Three or four, Fire Nation is saying. Yeah, but now he can go into fish traps. And he's Kells, so he has more wood. So
Yes.
maybe it's worth
LB10
it.
had actually 3 shorefish, I think, there, so it's okay. And he has enough wood to build at least one TC instantly, but the second TC will follow shortly.
Yeah, of course, he has the resources already.
Yeah, even though you build like how many fish traps? 5, 6, and all those fishing ships. Cats are amazing. Look at Project Bertram, what he's doing though. Castle
See?
dropping.
No.
Yes.
That would
He
be
doesn't.
amazing, since it would deny the possibility for LB10 to go further into walling there.
Yeah.
He's
No,
going
back.
he just wanted
Let's
to
go
chop
forward.
those this
Yeah.
6 wood.
Okay.
Is
Last
Abby
rock in the
ten
castle.
able to see it? I think not, since it, oh, well, he sees it, he sees it, he sees it. Okay, that's unfortunate.
Should be. Yes.
So now his only chance to defend against this is to wall behind, right?
Yeah, well, heavily behind here with stone walls, maybe.
But LB10 doesn't have any stone.
That's true.
This could be interesting.
Clear.
So okay,
Also.
of course, Belgium needs to go for some special strats.
Yeah, he bought stone. Oh no, that's too close.
Oh man. Belgium needs to go for some special strats, since he has no chance against against Kels.
Late game is very tough with Burgos against Kels.
So we have the 19-minute aggression in Black Forest.
It's nice, and he's building a petard too. Like, he wants to go there quickly
He's
for the
going for
walls.
camel archers. Yeah, he definitely wants to rush.
Yes.
Petards and then rush with camel archers. This could actually be pretty strong.
But look at Abitain, he's even close to like double layer walling this already.
Why is he wasting the petard into the? Oh, of course, he needs his camel archers to deny him
Yes.
from
Deny
buying.
the wall. From denying the double wall and everything.
Oh man, what is he doing there? University for Abitan. Oh no, Mangano as well for LB10. Let's see what there's going.
Well, Mangano is going to be important.
The Mangano could actually change the. Oh no, this Camel Archer will do. Oh man, oh man,
Oh
losing three
no.
villagers to one single Mangano shot. Losing the scout as well. Now, he will lose the petards. Oh.
Titanic, indeed.
He can't afford to lose those petards. He definitely cannot.
Well, he can't do anything with those petards now anyway because he doesn't have any camel archers.
Oh no, okay, this game is absolutely lost. Okay, no, it's not. Shouldn't say that this early, but.
Considering the saves and the amount of fields he is behind, it's kind of lost, I agree.
Yeah, okay, maybe it is. So we are 20 minutes in Black Forest, and LB10 already has a 12 villager lead. Project
Yes.
Belgium. Project Belgium was forced to buy 500 food.
He wants to click up. He wants to trap.
Oh.
He has to do something happen now. He has to make something happen now. Like, he can't wait until late game. He knows that.
No, he definitely can't wait until late game.
And he knows that he can't catch up in booming. And look, Abitain even has those eight fishing ships with gill nets. It's such a huge eco advantage. 15 villagers, eight fishing ships with gill nets.
But LB10, not LB10, Project Belgium has enough stone to build another castle, but where should he place it?
Maybe I will chop this one Straker tree and build it right behind the wall.
This would be very interesting as
Oh, the
well.
Mangonel! Oh no, the Mangonel could. The Mangonel could. Like, if he tries to build the castle, then the Mangonel is shooting immediately, the castle will die. But it doesn't. Abitain didn't pay attention. That could have been so bad for Project Belgium.
If you predicted a shot and killed the castle, like in this moment where it was supposed to go up.
That's what I thought, and he even saw it, like he saw it with the monks, right? He had the line of sight, but.
He wasted the monk into the castle. That's unf Oh man, what is he? He can't just go through the gate there and snipe those villies. If he can catch him off guard. Okay, no. Belgium is paying attention.
Oh no, they have to micro now all the time.
Oh, and he's not paying attention.
Oh
Losing.
boy.
Losing his forward villagers. He just have two villagers left. Oh man, this. And he's even going for fortified walls. Okay, this is going to be a fastlock game. And Belgium is up on Imperial Age. LB10, not even close to. LB10 is housed as well. Oh man. Oh, and LB10 is trying to convert those villagers, I think. It would be the. And he's. No, he's wasting his mangonel into the castle. What is he doing there?
I didn't know that Belgium researched Bodkin Arrow.
And
Oh
he's
no, he
losing his
split it.
last two
Oh
villagers!
my. Oh my god. Well, he has half the, not even half the population of early 10 right now, so that's good.
So he
It's fine.
needs to go all in or nothing. So he has to do all in. No other chance there.
Early
LB10
10.
is building a castle as well, but way more behind. He doesn't have the resources to click up right now. And oh man, he landed a pretty damn good shot on those camel archers there, although. Oh, the Fire Nation just mentioned it. Project Bankium doesn't even have a loom.
Oh yeah, they
Oh
really don't.
man. It's just Titanic. This castle is getting so much. And now LB10 needs instantly to build some trebuchet, and he is. And no, please pay attention, Belgium. You can't afford it one more time. And now he's losing his. Oh.
This is so messy. This castle is down to like almost half the HP just because of those manganese shots, but now it's going up.
And Belgium even doing Bracer. Oh man, he was. He's just. It's not, oh, okay. He needs his trebuchet now.
LB10 is up though, and he can repair this castle forever.
That's true.
I mean, I don't want to kill the hype, but I still think it's kind of over. Like, if Project Belgium is winning this man, then
Project
I'm gonna give
Belgium
him.
using his trebuchet efficiently, killing the house. Okay, now no, he wants to cut through there and get in with camel
That's a good
archers.
move. That's a good move,
But
but LB10 is gonna have
LB10
this.
is expecting this and walls off.
Yes. That was a good idea, actually.
I think this is a situation where we can see that we are facing two pretty good players here.
Yes. Well, Project Bastion could still try to cut like above those walls, right next to the castle.
Yeah, but it's, I think it's pretty hard to cut there because you don't know how. He still has one petard left. He could go through this wall, through the gate.
No, this petard is not enough to bring down a fortified gate, I think.
No, but he has trebuchets as well, and now Project Belgium will see that he will. But no, LB10 messed up his wall. He can just go through there.
He won't go through all this manganese of this castle.
But okay, yeah, okay, yeah, okay, yeah. I didn't say anything. Oh no, those mangonels. Oh, hoo-hoo! Every tennis player, the Belgium is paying attention. Hey,
Yeah,
it's
you can easily out micro there.
pretty good micro.
His cannon archers are so good against manganese. The extra damage they have and.
They have extra damage against mangonels?
No, but they have more damage than normal archer units, right? They have 7 base damage. So you
LB10
gotta.
and Imp as well. If Project Belgium is able to win this. Oh man. Like, LB10 is
Like.
not even repairing his castle. It's looking pretty good for Belgium right now.
Yeah, he's letting him die.
What is happening there? The castle is
Castle
down. He can just
down.
go in with those camel archers. He can easily out-micro the mangonels.
Oh yeah, LB10 is researching manager, but it takes a lot of time.
It's too late to apologize. Okay, never mind.
Oh boy. Well, this thing is
He's
dying without
wasting
even
all his
trying to shoot.
mangonels. Not even able to repair it. Now he can rush the whole echo. Project Belgium even has the score lead.
Oh man.
What is happening there? He's
That should
even.
never happen.
What is happening there? Like, what the fuck?
And now he has onager.
He's now walking in with all of his trebuchets.
Everton still doesn't have like real units. Yes, onagers, yes, but they can get out micro pretty easily. And apart from that, he has no units. And look at his economy, like look at this woodland right next to the TC. It's a mess right
What
now.
is happening here?
The problem for Project Belgium is just that he has basically no economy. He can't afford anything.
He can't afford to lose anything. He just needs to. Maybe he can do some attack ground with the trebuchets against the onagers if he's lucky.
He would need to out-micro those 5 onagers right now, but that would be tough.
As Fire Nation is mentioning right now, Boogum is getting chemistry. Maybe he wants to go for the bombard cannons.
Yes, that will be important.
And he's able to rush this woodliner. Oh man!
So many wolves are going to die, man.
Oh shit! This is a massacre. Oh, what the fuck, man! What is happening here? Now he needs to show us his micro skills.
Oh boy.
Oh.
He doesn't have blood lines. They're dying so easily.
No, he can't afford to lose those. Man, this split was way too late. Is he able to snipe? Is he able to snipe the onager? Come on, please kill now. You're losing all your camera assets. You can't do that. No, he lost his whole army. He can't afford that. He doesn't have the resources to rebuild this. Now he's getting bloodlines. Now he recognized. Oh yes, man. But he still has the score lead. What is happening here? I'm kind of enthusiastic right now. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's cool. It's really interesting that Project Bertha is making this game interesting.
This is...
I'm saying interesting too much, but yeah.
This is just insane. What I like.
Yes.
Like, but Belgium knows, okay, he definitely has the Civ advantage, and LB10 felt safe because he had the Civ advantage. So he maybe never expected Belgium to go so aggressively, and I think that was... Oh man, we will see one more engagement here. He almost killed his own Mangonels there. No pay! Yo, that's not those
Oh, nice micro!
That's micro!
Ah, he hit one.
But it's not that bad anymore because he has bloodlines. He's killing those onagers. What is going on here?
He's preventing the walling.
I've never seen a Black Forest game this interesting before. Black Forest 1v1 at this level is even in. That's in. Like, how?
Such an entertaining game. Oh, it's on my going again.
He can walk through. He just need to. And he almost kills his own Rams there with the Mangonel. LB10 is completely not getting over the situation. And there's the Knight of Belgium. It can easily kill the battering Rams.
I wanted to say, he's bringing a Knight in, and LB10 doesn't even have a barracks right now. Now he's building a Vault Raider, but that doesn't do it too much.
The Ward Raider will die pretty heavily against those Camel Archers.
Yes, and the Knight will kill the Rams easily.
What is happening here? Onagers. He can just snipe the Onagers with his Knights, man. Peyton, no! Don't lose your army there!
Kill the trap.
Just snipe, no!
Quite a few Camel Archers.
Don't lose your army. You can't afford that, okay. Onagers are sniped.
LB10 is spamming onagers like crazy.
He has no other chance since he has no barracks right now.
Yeah, he has to.
He needs to. He needs
the
to
only
do
option he has right now.
Yeah.
And his economy is hurting.
How can this game be so close, man? And this knight sniping those onagers.
Now the spearmen are coming.
Why is this knight doing so much damage?
Oh man. One knight killing all those onagers.
Oh man. No spearman for... And the only thing LB10 killed was his own spearman.
Oh no. All those onagers are going to die.
Oh man, this was a single knight killing all those onagers. And boom! What is happening here? This...
This is back and forth.
Husbandry right now, he will need that for the micro, but man, what is this game? It's just... Oh, it's so close! Like, Belgium basically playing all in for about 40 minutes now.
Yes, but he has to, it's the only chance he has.
What is this? Oh, and this onager will die as well?
Oh no.
Good micro, Belgium. Good micro. Good micro again. Good micro again. What is this happening here? Losing his whole army again.
Dead.
Where is Google micro? Person.
Oh yes. Doesn't have camera archers anymore. This is giving LB10 some time to breathe.
Belgium needs to take down the siege workshop. That's true. He's already attacking them, and both of the siege workshops are just low as. Man, what is this game?
Well, LB10 is pikeman already, so...
But those pikemen are not that strong if you consider microing, so like with hit and run, those camel archers. But
yes, but they're gonna be annoying by, while they're out microing the onages, right?
And the only thing LB10 kills are his own pikemen again.
Yes, oh boy.
Now he's able to snipe those frigging onagers with just three camel archers. Man, what is what is going on here?
It's becoming a micro scenario right now for
yeah, it's just a micro scenario, right?
Oh no, oh.
He can't afford losing his army one more time. Man, snipe this onager, don't lose your...
Oh no. Yeah, but that's what I said. When he tries to fight those onagers straight up, those pikemen will come in.
Why is this knight idling there? He needs the knight to snipe the onagers. But I think the game now turns more and more into the favor of LB10.
Project Bertram has a lot of resources and he has two TCs even, like he could catch up a little bit.
But you need to consider, Belgium does have more resources than LB10.
Yeah. So Bertram could use this even more, like if he wants to play all in, he has to play really all in. And like, he has chemistry, right? He has easily the resources to build Bombard Cannons now. And Bombard Cannons could change the game as long as every 10 has just onages.
I bet they are both sweating right now. And now he could snipe all those pikemen with the camel archers and go in with the knights again.
Yep. Every 10 doesn't have the best upgrades on them. He's still missing the imp upgrade on the defense there. He's doing it now, but he doesn't have the upgrade and doesn't have enough gold to do so. But actually looking at LB10, he's not collecting any gold right now. Right? His only gold mine is forward, where the camel archers are.
Another Onager coming in, good micro by Belgium, he's paying attention. He's paying attention one more time, he needs to snipe the Onager, come, split! Oh, okay, he doesn't need to split. Pull your knight out there, you will need it again. And now he has one more time the possibility to go into the Echo and raid.
Every 10 is out of gold, man. He can't produce onagers anymore.
What?
Yes, he has no gold, he can't collect gold.
Man, he has only one gold pile and that's in the front where Project Belgium is. He can now just easily kill all of those pikemen. I'm not getting over it.
Winning this, what the fuck?
And he now can even kill the Siege Workshop with the Camel Archers. I can't get over this, man. This game is so intense.
Can now move in and kill, like, easily. Oh no, one Onager still.
I think we have a harder time casting this than these guys playing.
Yes, Everton has sold a lot of resources to just get a little bit of gold.
What is happening? LB10 can't resign here. I think he would hate himself if he resigns here. He can't do that.
Man. And the will count is getting closer, if you look at that.
How can the will count getting close, man? This is not possible.
Oh, Everton must kick his own ass. Like, he sold all his resources to get the gold to research Halberdier. His economy is dead bad right now.
How is this possible? LB10 even going for hail, but Project Belgium has elite camel archers. I don't know if you mentioned it.
No, I didn't. Wow, that's great. And like, oh, onager.
I guess this is really one of the best Black Forest games ever recorded.
Like, you should never win with Berbers against Chaos, and he's in a winning position. Like, he's 1,400
like,
points.
Like, even those trebuchets can tank now, so he's able to kill... Man, I can't talk anymore. So he's able to kill those Halebards with the Camel Archers. And this
That's
works.
That's ridiculous, man.
How is this possible? He's raiding the whole Echo.
Oh man.
Brodus is riding actually my favorite game of all times. I hope so, man. This
That's
game is ridiculous.
And Everton still doesn't collect any gold. Needs to rely on selling. And his one relic. That's the only thing that's giving him gold right now. He's losing wills. He can't fight with Halberdiers against Camel Archers as long as the Camel Archers can micro well.
This game is basically over. But not now. Now the Camel Archers are trapped.
Himself.
They are trapped. Get out there quickly. No. You can't do that. You can't do that. Please, please.
Oh, not like this, Belgium.
Man, Belgium, you can't afford to lose your whole army there. This is not. But look at Belgium's resources. He can't afford it, actually.
Yes, But it's still bad.
Oh man, you can't do that!
But Abitan has the resources to produce habitus infinitely. Like, look at this barracks. He has like 12 habitus cured in all of those.
Oh, now scorpions for Belgium, imagine that.
Scorpions? Yeah, that would be nice.
But not against Onegas.
Nope.
What is happening here? This game is turning into the favor of everyone.
Project Belgium has so many resources. It needs to get them on the map now.
We should do organize those show matches way more often.
Yeah, it's great.
This makes so much fun.
And I was actually like saying Black Forest shit map.
I think Black Forest is the best game, by far the best game we had today.
Of the series, yeah.
Yeah.
But just down to the Sif matchup and like how YOLO Project Belgium has to play this to win this.
Like Project, it isn't the first game Project Belgium played completely YOLO. But I mean, so far it works, why does it work?
So far it was RB10 playing full YOLO all the time, right? With the tower rush in the first game and everything. Man, this is...
I think maybe it is good when they are not playing that safe because of there is no prize pool.
But they're giving them like they're giving everything. Like there were like 3-4 spots where Project Belgium could have resigned, and I would have said, yeah, it's true, you can resign there, right? But he's still playing on, and well, he's now in a great spot still.
Yeah, snipe this and also pay attention to your
No, Punishers are dead, killing more halberdiers than Camel Archers.
Not having a prize pool is actually an advantage. Yeah, of course it is! And the only thing LB10 killing here are his own... Hailbards, man. Oh, those splits, man, those splits, this is working. The Vill count is getting close as well, thanks Brodus for mentioning it. Look at the Vill counts. This is just not possible.
Yes, 78 to... 69, it's amazing. And Project Belgium is not even creating villagers right now.
Like, this is a game where both, like, both can't afford to lose. It's just a game where both can win, it's kinda open.
The all or nothing game.
It's the all or nothing game, it's a frigging final, it's the last game of the series. Man, what is this?
Abitain is back on gold, that's good for him.
And Belgium raiding one more time.
Oh, it needs to prevent RB10 from getting gold.
Oh, what is he doing here?
RB10 even accidentally ungarrisoned his one relic he had.
Oh, what the...
I don't know how he did that.
Oh man, pay attention to your cannon!
Oh no.
Oh no. How hard
is he? He's trapped again.
No, he's... Okay, yeah, basically he is, but he... Just snipe this Onega.
There's enough room to micro.
Yeah, but he is uphill.
Uphill, yeah. I think he can out micro those, right?
He can easily out micro them.
Yes. Well, now he's killing on the gold again.
Look at the score difference, man. It's 3,000 point score difference in the favor of Project Belgium.
Yes, and Project Belgium now has more villagers than LB10.
This is just not possible. How is LB10 winning this?
What is this game?
not LB10, Belgium, man. Those names are confusing. I am confusion. Oh, and he can he will now find the gold. No, he will not. But he needs LB10 is getting Project Belgium to his second gold. He can't do that. He needs to retreat because he can't push them to his second gold.
Oh, I didn't see it. He's getting gold there, actually. Yeah, that's true.
Oh, and he's paying attention. Micro's so good. Micro so good here.
The Project Belgium can see that there's a gold mine, so he should probably check it out, right?
Oh, LB10 the GG! Man, this was a great series!
This was
a freaking great series. Man. Oh.
I put the broomstick back in the closet because I'm done sweeping Project Belgium.
I don't find any words. Best final ever, of course, man. That was by far the greatest final I've ever saw.
That was one of the greatest games of Age of Empires I've ever saw. Yeah. Man, that was interesting.
And we had the honor to cast it, man.
Yes. Amazing, man.
And I recorded it so it will last forever on YouTube, man. Oh, shit. Oh, man, 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 man. Very great games.
Very great games indeed.
This was a damn good final, man. So, okay, guys, if you want me to do this in the future more times as well, so just leave a follow if you haven't yet. Leave a follow for Jake. I will do a shout out for him as well.
Was not even streaming.
He oh, definitely deserves it. Winner interview. No, we can do a losers interview. It's great as well, man. It's great as well. Hey, Albiton.
Hello, man.
How you doing, man? How you doing?
How is my sound doing on Discord? Because usually I use only TeamSpeak because my Discord is meh.
Right now it's okay.
It works.
Can hear me fine then.
Yeah, it's okay.
Okay. First of all, Albiton.
That was a bit embarrassing.
This was the greatest final of any series I was ever able to see and ever able to cast, of course. Man, hilarious.
You can be lucky that I failed in game 4, because otherwise it would have been 4-0.
Philos, thanks a lot for gifting a sub to Project Pergium.
He deserves it.
Yes.
Oh man, highly appreciate it. Thank you, Philos. Have fun with those emotes, Belgium. Oh man, I'm completely exhausted from casting. I think Jake as well.
Yeah, my right hand is a bit hurting as well.
This was just so it was so stressful to cast. It was just so stressful to even watch the stream, I think. So,
like, just all this micro against the onagers all the time. Like, you just have to focus on that.
I wasn't attack ground shooting well enough, I think.
It was just amazing, man. It was just amazing.
Micro was also sometimes on the sloppy side, but
yeah, I know.
Oh boy.
I think you see the difference between us and top 10 world players.
But it made it very, very interesting series, definitely.
Yeah, well, they're fun to watch.
Yeah, I think it was an advantage not to have a prize pool, and it was an advantage that you were not the top 10 players, because we saw high level gameplay, but we also saw some YOLO and all in gameplay. We wouldn't ever We saw gameplay we wouldn't be ever able to see if we had some top 10 players with a $1,000 prize pool.
You want to go through the map? Shot? I think I can have 5 or 10 more minutes if you want.
Yeah.
Of course. So, Jake, I think you're more into the questions than me, so...
Oh, I have to remember what happened. First game was Arabia.
I have the list with the maps and see if I can tell you.
The first map was Arabia, right? Incas against Ethiopians. The heavy tower rush game. Yes. Was the Tower Rush basically a decision because of the Civ matchup, or was it because of your map with the like heavy forward gold?
No, it wasn't about my map. It was more that he had both two stone spot at the same screen, which then in the end I didn't really attack. I came more from the gold and berries, but
yes,
he defended it quite well, I think. Maybe attack from the stone side and not from the gold side.
Yes. Do you think that
he could just make defensive tower after defensive tower?
Yeah. Do you think Project Belgium kind of threw the game when he had his like crossbows under your towers? Like, he wasted like 10 crossbows there, basically.
I think he felt like he needed to do damage, because if I get eagles, he's dead.
Yeah, that's true.
Like, that's how it ended, basically. After two towers I had were necessary, they saved me.
Yes.
If I only have one, I die.
Yeah, that's true. But you can just camp under it, right?
Saw both, or if he just went in on the first one and then saw the second and... didn't want to go back or something.
Okay, it's a good decision you're making the questions, man. So you're way more into it than me. I can't even remember those games. I'm completely exhausted.
For Project Bertram,
yeah, and my Inca villagers were amazing with +1/+1.
Oh yeah, it's true. You can always win the villagers, right?
Yeah, I was instantly fighting his scams and archers.
Yeah,
as well.
That's true. Yeah, so I wasn't able to do much damage with this, like, early archers and skirms he had in feudal age, because...
Yeah, but I also think I didn't do too much damage with my towers, did I? So...
Well, it made it very messy for Project Belgium, and he had a lot of idle time. Like, he had... Like, especially...
Yeah,
Like, he had one wood line, and you were very annoying on it with your towers back there.
That's what you have to do. You have to be annoying.
Yes, definitely. And do you think, like, for Ethiopians in that matchup, shoulders are the best option, like, or the only option?
The only option, I think, as well.
Like, you can't do much apart from that.
Against all Mesosifs, maybe not Mayans, but against everything else, Aztecs and Incas.
And Slingers, like, don't they hard counter them, or do they just get overrun by
Slingers? Then again, he's making Archer and he's countering my Slingers, so.
Yeah, that's true. But he wasn't in a position to do that just because he didn't have the economy, so.
Well, that's how it ended.
Yeah, of course. So yeah, game 2 Nomad, that was pretty straightforward, right? It's like,
no, I knew he would ban my Melian, so I picked the second Nomad Civ.
Persians, yeah, that we expected that. And like, did you expect Aztecs from him?
Let me check the draft again. Of it, but yeah, it's the most obvious choice.
Okay, but maybe like we were thinking, okay, Aztecs are even stronger on most of the other maps usually, like especially on Arena, I would have picked Aztecs, but
Wills and faster moving ships, so they have like 2 bonuses and cheaper knights, so I think they can be good on Nomad as well, Berbers,
yeah, it's true,
but yeah, he. And then, yeah, game 3 Arena was pretty straightforward as well, I think.
Yeah. It was just booming.
I used the melee power, even if my start wasn't the best.
You were housed, right? In Feudal Age.
Yeah, yeah. I lost 1 pop. Yeah, fun Feudal 2 castle on 30 pop.
Yes, exactly.
And I lost, but still melee is super strong. And
yeah.
The best game, I clicked up way too late to
Budapest, right?
To Feudal, I had over 1k food, and I only then clicked to Feudal.
Yeah, we saw that. You didn't have gold and like 1k food. It was a little bit messy.
No problem. I could have sold. I just needed to go up quicker.
Yes. But that's just what Budapest gives you, right? It was very messy.
It was a bit messy because of the scouts and the wills in the middle fighting, and then I forgot to click up, I think, and I had 2 docks running.
Yeah,
I think
exactly.
If I get the castle up and I click 1 minute earlier, I'm winning the game.
Can I throw in one?
The castle on the hill. No, you can't.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did you have the impression that you and Belgium were balanced? Or
for skill-wise?
Repeat it, please. And Terrorless, thanks for the follow. No, I missed it. Yeah, I will upload it on YouTube so you can watch
Wait,
the whole
one second,
thing again. Okay. Terrorless, the final game, so the 7th game was just... It was incredible.
It was amazing.
It was just amazing. And I think we also did a pretty decent job casting it.
Yeah, we had to find ourselves into it, right? We were talking about over each other in the beginning, but
yeah,
we figured it out.
That's what I wanted to say for you guys in the stream chat as well right now. I want you guys, and Jake, I think as well, to give us feedback. Do you want to?
Yes.
To get some feedback? So you can either just flame us in the chat now or join the Discord and post it in the feedback channel, or just write me or Jake a direct message on Twitch. It does matter, but we just want some feedback because I think it was our first really casting.
Yes, it was the first time I was ever casting, and for you probably as well.
Yeah,
first cast.
I think it was the first time I actually casted with some background information and stuff.
Yeah.
Philos is saying it was okay.
It was okay, yeah.
It was okay.
It was quite okay. That's good. Good for me.
Okay, I'm back, sorry.
Yeah,
No problem, man.
No problem, man.
So the Budapest game, I also thought the Spanish are very strong, right? If you place a cast on that hill, like with those golds and stones, we were talking about that. That could have been so
My
awkward
first...
for him.
Been Chinese for Budapest, of course.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
And maybe it even would have been Indians.
Yeah.
For those, so Spanish was my third choice for it.
Yeah, but Spanish are great on Budapest, that's true.
And I think I did 2 dogs, he only did 1, right?
Yeah, he did 1, yes.
So the longer the game gets, the better for me it is.
Yes, but...
Even taking more legs and Kong, that would have been... But yeah, I don't know.
Right now we passed a solid 4 hours.
That was worth it.
Oh, it definitely was.
The game, for the
Gold
games he
Rush.
won. Gold Rush was. I think I had an advantage in Feudal Age with the
Yes.
scouts and scrums.
Bertram went for a weird approach, like
Yeah,
just
I didn't
straight
get the
one archer
scout he was
range.
doing, but
Yes.
I don't know, even maybe it wasn't good. And then yeah, he had I couldn't really never really fight the mass expos here. Maybe I should have played more knights in Castle Age and more aggressive.
So
Instead
you
of going
think,
in.
yeah, probably like full Castle
Yeah.
Age would have been better, you say,
Yeah, in
or?
a second castle. I think like
On Gold Rush, Belgium's approach, as Jack already mentioned, was kind of weird, but it worked. So I don't know why, but it was kind of interesting how it worked, because the
I
whole
think I needed just more knights, more knights, more knights. Maybe even instead of the elite scrums, just go full knights.
but
Full
the
knights and just raid the hell out of him, right? And like build those
yeah,
Frank
and
castles, the
push
cheap
him
castles
with siege,
around him.
push him with siege forward castles and Franks.
Yeah, that's Franks. How they play them, it's true.
Even if he goes imp, he just can kill some castles forward, even then.
Yeah.
Well.
And then you have the hill, right? You would starve him out of gold all the
yeah.
time.
Like this, I had the hill, but then I kind of lost the trap. Well, I don't know why. I think, was he imp before me?
He was imp before you, yes.
That's why I lost the trap, probably. And yeah, I didn't repair it enough. And his Arbalest did a lot of good, that was.
Yeah, that was a good move.
Ideal. I should have stonewalled earlier.
And he also, like, researched in the end. It was pretty late, but then, like, the last trap war, he won basically because of a war wolf.
Oh yeah, I didn't even think about that, but that makes a lot of sense, of course.
Yeah.
I was just wondering why you were taking those trap fights, but then we realized you don't know about.
Yeah, you probably won't
yeah,
think
right,
about in this situation.
I think Warwolf is one of those techs you, at least
yeah.
I forget most.
You see it very rarely. It's true.
But in those situations, it's amazing, of course.
Yeah, it's very strong. So then the Serengeti game, that was interesting.
Serengeti game was just so the longer the series got, the better the games were, in my opinion.
Yeah.
No matter which matter which map
games.
You played.
That's why I lost.
So build just more towers in your own base and go like full heavy tower defense.
Oh,
with
instead
it.
Of making them with his base, I started making them in my base. That wasn't bad. But yeah, against Mongols, of course, on that map.
Oh yeah.
Actually, I was thinking of Kilimanjaro. When before the draft and everything, I was surprised to see that net.
Okay. I saw you didn't.
Mistake,
okay, yeah.
I was thinking of another one. Yeah.
Seraphs are. I don't know if Seraphs are actually the best Sith for Serengeti, right? Because you get to farms pretty late and you're so open. Because you have
what
all
what else should
food.
I have picked?
Yeah, it's true. Like maybe Franks from your Sith pool, but apart from that.
Yeah, but then again, I thought it was the other map, and
yeah, I know
that the map doesn't have berries, so
yeah, that's true.
Considering I need to get up to early tomorrow, maybe I would end it here if there are no more important questions.
We have to talk about the Black Forest game, right? Just shortly, at least.
I give you 5 minutes. It's no problem.
Like,
5 minutes. Yeah, well, I should have just walked on the BF game. I can never let him in with his first.
One question
better, right?
from me. You never expected him to go that all in, right?
No, I because it's like it. I knew it was his only chance of winning because my eco
yes.
must have been so much better, even with the lake and everything. So I knew, if I don't lose the lake, I won that game. And then somehow I started losing it, and yeah. Then it backfired.
Yeah. And then he can just use his mobility all the time and raid you and.
I should just never let him in and play Kel's power with a lot of eco. But
yes, if you're just fighting a choke point, he has no chance, right? Then it will be tough.
Yeah, but he played that well too.
Yes. So yeah, man. I don't want Finn to be.
Oh, it's no problem. If you have
tomorrow.
Some more questions, no.
I'm tired as well. Like
it's okay. I'm tired as well.
I've played so much the last days.
Okay.
It's hurting to playing this much. And I even lost rating, man. I was up super high after being up 3-4, 3-0.
You know, we were talking about it. You were overtaking Project Virgin in the rating. Like you were 2K2.
Let me check again. How much do I have now? 2170.
LB10. Thanks for
Thank
those
you for
games.
The games, man.
Thank you for inviting.
No problem.
See you next time.
I have to give 100% of the respect to you because you played without any prize pool.
Right, of course. Like, we are friends and it's Pugum, so.
Okay, man. Next time there will be a prize pool, and maybe you will get something small as well.
We can invite us again.
Okay. I would take it serious, man.
I mean, like, I love doing those show matches. I don't get.
You love doing losing against Berbers on Black Forest as scouts.
that's a bit embarrassing, but other than that.
Yeah, next time only BF, man.
Yeah, of course, Fire, of course, man. We're doing a pro Black Forest show match, best of 13.
We only had one. Didn't?
Yeah, you didn't pick islands. I thought it was big islands.
I would love to see some more water maps. So maybe continental or islands would be cool. But
we both, yeah. Continental. Well, like continental is a weird one.
Yeah, maybe even Baltic or something like that.
Like, yeah, Baltic,
Mediterranean.
LB10, was the map pool okay, or did you miss?
What not? You can even put more. You can even put more standard maps in, but that's fine. It was maybe
maybe next time we will just the map pool is just every standard map in the game.
Don't necessarily need to put Black Forest in.
Of course, man. Of course. Who did pick Black Forest?
He did.
I did.
Oh man. Okay.
Need Mongolia inside because everybody hates Mongolia because of the cliffs.
Yes.
But other than that, it's nice. It's a nice pool.
Okay.
With the bands is fine as well done in the end.
Thanks for the game.
So, yeah.
See ya.
Hope you had some fun.
Oh man.
Oh, we really definitely had.
It's nice. Congratulations, Bugum. You deserved it a bit.
He definitely did.
Alright, bye.
Good night.
Good night. Also for you, Jack AOE, thanks for casting with me. It was an honor to cast with you. A honor, no, not an honor. I always say an honor, but it doesn't make any sense.
That was so fun to watch.
It was so fun. I need to watch the whole stream again tomorrow.
Oh yeah.
It's only 4 hours. Yeah. Okay. I will stop the stream and the recording now. I think we're going to host anyone. Let's see who we can host. Let's host Odette. I don't need to explain why. Let's just host Odette. Great stream, Fire, thank you. See you guys. Thanks for the follows. Thanks for the subs. We will see each other. I think it will definitely not be the last time I will organize something like this. It was so much fun, and LB10 even did say we can just invite him. And
Bertrand would be up for that as well, I can imagine.
Yeah, I think he had lots of fun as well.
There has to be a rematch between those two. That was amazing.
So thanks guys for tuning in. Thanks for the support today. Bye.
Bye-bye.